This is the outlet of Island Pond, and we got to decide on the outlet here if we take out somewhere up there. We might be able to paddle all the way through there. Okay, the end of Island Pond, getting ready to go into the Clyde River via paddling underneath the hotel. There we are. The question is, can Tim get under there? That's what we're looking at. John made it through okay. Dundee's going under. The old days, they claim when you get halfway through, you could pick up the, they could pick up your canoe or kayak and you could stay there for the night. So Tim's getting ready to go in, just a mild, easy current. Looks like he's gonna be able to go under. Okay, we were concerned about his height. So we'll see. Okay, I'm getting closer here. I'm getting closer. I'm trying to paddle. Keep the camera going. I'm going underneath. I'm underneath now. Tim's there ahead of me. And it looks, trying to steer with one hand here. Very easy current. Very easy current here. Huh. This looks like back there. Can you see where they used to pull the canoes up?
Right here.
Right there?
Yeah.
Wow.
Or maybe on that side. So both of these sides, there's a chamber in there as big as this one is here.
Wow. Fascinating. Fascinating. Tim and John are under. I've got the duck here. I tell you. And I'm going to turn the camera and see if I can get Dundee coming out.
A lot of people will leave
him
up here.
Job, Dundee. Ooh, John doesn't want me to ping into him. Just missed it. Okay. Good job, John. Better put the camera away. Good job, Tim. Coming through, fallen tree. A lot of twisting and turning. And they were twisting and turning. Just see John go by there. The whole thing is zigzagging, the Clyde River. Looks like we are stuck here. There's a log completely across, and I don't think we're gonna be able to paddle over it. So we may have to get out and go around it. Let's see. Like John's gonna have to pull over because his kayak is really too long to make it. So Dundee's gonna try to help him. Trying to turn him right on the log. Here's Tim coming through with Dundee's help. It's amazing he can balance on that log. He's balancing on a log and helping make that turn.
Okay, you want to jump in with me?
No, go ahead.
All right, I'm good.
From my own experience, you can see it from the front of the container.
We go, as you can see, there's more curves. Here we go, Tim. Good job, Tim. Thank you, Dundee. Nice job.
I wanted to try some stunt canoeing from the front, John.
I was gonna say, you need my help. Facing the other way.
There they go. We're off. Many beaver dams here. This one looks like about a foot higher than the stream that we're in. So how far are we to 5 miles now, Dundee?
We're halfway from Island Pond to 5 mile takeout.
Okay.
And then we have another twice as far to go from Island Pond to 5 mile is half the distance that we have to take to 10 miles.
Okay, and I think we left, about 2 o'clock. So we've been about an hour or so. It's about 3 o'clock now.
So we might make it by 6.
Okay.
If we paddle.
Interesting paddle, isn't it? Oh, the beaver fells and the dams that we've had to go over and trees.
Current's moving nice.
I like the current. I like the water level.
Nice and clear too.
Yep.
Not paddling in brown.
Yep.
Yeah, nice clear water.
It's a fun trip.
you.
There you go, almost.
John's coming through. Big branch. We don't even have no water. We're trying to go up with a log by pulling the branch. Good job, John.
Normally, as we approach log dams and other obstacles in the river, we slow and check the area for our approach, and then go through one person at a time, waiting to make sure each person safely gets through before the next person goes. When we know rapids are ahead, we stop before the rapids and scout the best way to go through the rapids. However, about 4 miles from our point in at Island Pond, I was the first person through one of the many fallen trees blocking the river, so we just assumed this was another block. And my intent was to paddle clear of this obstacle and wait for my fellow paddlers. However, the fallen tree was on a bend, and when I made it through the barrier on the bend, I immediately found myself in Class 2 whitewater without a place to pull out and wait for the next paddler. Essentially, I was committed to what looked like Class 2 rapids with boulders and small drops, not really knowing how rough they were nor how long they would last. I was safely able to make it through this 200-yard set of rapids. I think I said in the clip 200 feet, but it was more like yards. And as you will see next, my friends did likewise. Enjoy this short movie clip made when I ran back on the riverbank, too late to warn my friends of their upcoming surprise, but certainly soon enough to get this clip for you.
Well, here are the rocks I just came through. Once we got off that log, but wow, it was quite a distance, maybe 200 or 300 feet to rapids like this all the way. It was fun, actually, after it's over. Here comes John. Good job, John. Fantastic. Nice job. Nice job. Super, super, super. Here comes Timothy. We never thought this was going to be like this coming down here, but here he is. Good job, Tim. Nice job. Looks good. Very good. Good job. Great. What a nice paddle. What a nice paddle. And I can see John below, so John made it. Oops. Tim got stuck on the rocks out there. Great job, Tim. Lots of rocks. Nice job. Experienced paddler did that one. Nice job, Tim. And Dundee should be coming along any second now. Here comes Dundee. Good job, Dundee. Everybody made it. Everybody made it. That was quite the surprise, isn't it, this area? We didn't know this was here. Great job. Good job, Tim. Woo! Woo! That was a toughie. Well, we're really stuck now. John's stuck between a little current and the whole thing is blocked off. So he's trying to just back out of there and go through the hole. I'm next, so I gotta watch him. I think I gotta go to the left. Tim's gonna try to come through. His canoe's very narrow. You have to turn at the last minute. No. Dundee's been an excellent guide and assistance in this. Good job, Tim. Tim, get through. We're at 5 mile road here, and Tim's getting to go through the tunnel. It's our halfway point for our trip for the day. Okay, so here I am at the going under the bridge at 5 mile road. I'm trying to paddle and also stay in a straight line so I remember, don't bump my head. We're gonna stop here for some water and then continue to the 10-mile road. Okay, we've had our water break, and it was at the 2-hour mark. So it took, it was at 2, 2 hours, so it's at 4 p.m. now. So we left Brighton Island Pond at the hotel, went under there somewhere around 2, and now it's 4 o'clock exactly. Now heading down the 10-mile takeout, and we expect that to be about a 2-hour trip, so here we go. Just an observation, the ecology between the 5-mile road and 10-mile road is completely different. This is an open area. We notice that the flow of the current is wider. No, that's not the flow, but the area we're paddling. We can see a lot of the mountains, and it's just a different area. And there's a lot of white cedar here. Beautiful mountains. We keep looking for a moose. This is moose country here. And somehow we should see a moose, but we have not seen one yet, so hopefully we will get it. Just trying to find it. We're approaching 10 mile road up here. You see the bridge right up there? Getting close. And there's a fellow paddler going by. There's Tim. And then over here, it looks like a great blue heron, or we even talked, maybe it's an osprey, we're not quite sure. Nest way up there. But notice the difference between this part of the Clyde than before when we before 5 Mile Road. There's the van up there. So you can see the van way up there. They left it earlier today, and it took us roughly 1 hour and 50 minutes to get from 5 Mile Road down to 10 Mile Road here. And it was an entirely different type paddle. So, beautiful day, beautiful evening. Looking forward to our camp dinner. We are picking up the Clyde. We skipped yesterday because of the rain and winter spectacle. And we're picking up at the 10 mile square put in where we put out on, took out on Monday. So we're getting ready to go. It's raining out now, but we expect it to stop or be intermittent, so we got about a 5-hour trip as our estimate down to Pensioner Pond. Now our second day on the Clyde. After the rainstorm, rivers come up about 6 inches. We estimate the flow of the water maybe 4 miles an hour, pretty fast. A lot of down trees here we're going through. You see one up there that we've got to go around there. So it's this is so far we've been through four. Whoa, I gotta put this down. Okay, another U-turn. We're coming up to the first bridge. I don't know if I can hold that, but as you can see, Timmy's way up there. First bridge from 10 mile square road. And it is overflowing. The bank's up here. We just passed a few curves that we could take shortcuts because it's overflowed. But we're in a U-turn here. You see Tim way over there? I hope I got him in the picture. It's hard to see. I tell you, the current's flowing so fast, John's going around the U-turn, that it's hard for me to take pitches. A lot of blowdowns and requires a fair amount of skill to get over and under him. So. As you can see, hopefully, John and Dundee going through and don't get what he's going on. He went on the right side, so I got to get ready to go. John's, looks like Dundee's going to go next, and then John. We're coming up to the school road bridge right now. This is the second bridge since 10 Mile Square Road, so we're going underneath there. Looks like we might be stopping. Yeah, I must indeed say the river's been fast. It's been flooded in spots. easily 6 to so inches higher than after the storm yesterday, but it's been fun. It's an obstacle course and some of these things. And we wait for Tim to get on his knees in front of us, and that means when he's paddling on his knees, there's something up there he's working on, so. And Dundee and Tim are now checking the map. How far is the school road bridge from 10 Mile Square Road?
I can't tell you that right off, but we've gone halfway to Pensioner Pond.
Ah, okay.
So what time is it now?
It's 12 o'clock.
And when did we put in?
10:30.
So we've got an hour and a half to go to take out.
Okay, we're about halfway.
So what I'd like to see, that's early, right? So the river is so fast that we're making good time. So I'd like to go see Todd Pond. So what we're going to do is we're going to paddle for a while. We're going to have a river coming in on the left, then one on the right. And then after a sharp turn, Todd Pond is on the left. I'd like to paddle up into Todd Pond and spend half hour paddling around Todd Pond. And then we can back on the river and from...
Tim, you've been a lead person. What have you thought of the river?
The river's flowing very fast and nice. You're doing more steering than paddling. In all the downed trees, the river's wide enough to go around them or through them. So obstacles-wise, the height of the river is really helping us with the rain.
Fantastic. Good job. And from those of us that are paddling behind you, when we see you get on your knees, we know it's time for us to prepare for something. So very good job.
Well, I got enough lower center of gravity that way.
Nice. Here we go. We've seen some interesting animals. We've saw 4 birds within 5 minutes, so different types of birds. I really couldn't tell you what they all were. I know we saw red-winged blackbird, some type of a woodpecker, a light brown bird, very small. Another one with a white belly and gray feathers and a black top. And I noticed since the school bridge, the river's widened much more and was slowed down. The current is not as fast as if we had been going, as if we were going before. We just saw an owl, a big owl.
Well,
Tim just signaled there might be something up ahead, so let's see what happens. Oh, he's going on his knees, so he saw something up there that requires really us to keep an eye open, watch our skills. Looks like there's a confluence of a second river here. Dundee's checking it in on the map because we need to find where it comes in, because just below that is when we go up the Todd Pond. So this is an interesting, this is a big field right here. Big field. We just spotted a mink, and then a few seconds later, we thought we saw a beaver. Now the beaver signs are obviously all over the place here, so the beaver here, we've seen one swimming, but I didn't know if I was going to get a picture, obviously, but not so. Coming to another U-turn. Okay, looks like we're coming up on the Pensioner Pond. So it's 2:05, so it's 3.5 hours took to get here, but we stopped for about 15 minutes and had a little lunch, so. And it's a little like some of the other Island Pond when we went around it starting this morning in the car had white caps, so we're going to see if it's windy out here now, because it's been windy in certain spots. Here comes John and Dundee, the edge cut across the corner, and I'm not sure if you can hear the wind here, but it's very difficult paddling. And there's Tim out there, and It might catch me with my breath. We are fighting the waves and fighting the wind. So we're almost up to the... Tim's working very hard, that's for sure.
Get out of the wind, get close to shore.
There's Dundee. And here comes John. Good job, John. How was the wind? And Tim's taking the shortcut, but he's got more of the wind than anybody else out there. Here we are, take out at the pensioner. You can see the public access. And just to the bottom of the left of the sign, in yellow and black, is the Northern Forest Canoe Trail sign. Doing a pensioner as I was paddling here, fighting the winds out there. John, this sort of reminds me of Lake Memphremagog, which is part of the Northern Forest Canoe Trail too. We had heavy winds out there one of the times we paddled it. Just like Memphremagog, Dundee, huh?
It's a little better, though.
A little easier than Memphremagog, that's true. And Tim out there paddling reminded me of the Allegash. You cut right across Eagle Lake in heavy winds on the Allegash, so interesting. Memories of other sections of the Northern Forest Canoe Trail. Fantastic. So 2 hours and 20 minutes, not 2 hours and 20 minutes, 2:20 in the afternoon. And what'd you think of the wind out there?
It was blustery.
And it's tougher paddling in the canoe, isn't it, huh?
Yeah, the wind controls you a lot.
That's true. Good job.
Do what you can.
Good job out there. Beautiful lake, isn't it? Water nice and clean, clear. Gorgeous. This is Outdoor Steve from the Northern Forest Canoe Trail at Island Pond, Vermont. We're just about to continue our excursion for section 6. Have a great day, and never say I wish I had been on the Northern Forest Canoe Trail.